All right, so far you have learned about property binding and its variations like class binding, style binding, and attribute binding to add something in the DOM to display data. In Angular, we also have event binding, which we use to handle events raised from the DOM, like keystrokes, mouse movements, clicks, and so on. So here we have a simple button, and we want to handle the click event of this button. So instead of square brackets, we use parentheses, and here we add the name of the event, like click. Then we bind this to a method in our component. So let's call this onSave. Now here I create this method onSave and simply log a message in the console. So console.log button was clicked. Let's try it. So here's our button, click. Now let's take a look at the console. Okay, here's the message. Now sometimes we need to get access to the event object that was raised in the event handler. For example, with mouse movements, the event object will tell us the X and Y position. If you want to get access to that event object, we need to add that as a parameter here. So $event. And then when calling this method, we also pass $event. This $event object is something known to Angular. Now, in this case, we're dealing with a DOM object, that's the button. So this $event object will represent a DOM event, a standard DOM event that you have seen in vanilla JavaScript and jQuery. Later, I will show you how to create custom components. And there, this $event object will represent a custom event that you define in your application. So back in our onSave method, let's log this event, $event, save, back in the browser. So one more time, click. Okay, here's our $event object. All these properties you see here are part of the standard DOM event objects. So we have the movement X and Y, offset X and Y, and many other properties. Now, all the DOM events bubble up the DOM tree unless a handler along the way prevents further bubbling. This is just a standard event propagation mechanism in DOM, and it's nothing specific about Angular. For example, let me wrap this button with a div like this. Now, in this div, I also want to handle the click event. So, parentheses, click, and I want to bind this to a different method. So let's call this onDivClicked. So let's add this method here, onDivClicked. And here I want to log a different message. Div was clicked. Now let's see what happens. So when we click this button, we get two messages in the console. The first one is the handler for the click event of the button, and the second is from the handler of the click event of the div. So this is what we call event bubbling. An event bubbles up the DOM tree. So to extend this example, if we had another div or another element that contained this div, and we handled the click event on that element, our event object will bubble up and hit that target handler. Now, how can we stop event bubbling? Well, here in onSave, we can call $event.stopPropagation. Again, this is a standard method you have seen before in vanilla JavaScript. So when we call this, this event will not bubble up. In other words, it's not going to hit the second handler. Let's try it. Save. Back in the browser. Click. Now look, in the console, we only have one message that's coming from the handler of the click event of the button.